Hey, I'm Stefan, and in this video I'm going to show you a bit less coding this time, but more explain to you the concepts of keys in AL and which properties are available for us to use. So I'm here on my first table, my demo table, and if you scroll down right beneath the fields section, you can also collapse it like this, you have the keys area. When you use your snippet, the t-table snippet, you will have already have a key named pk, stands for primary key, and in our example this has the entry number as its only field. You'll notice that it also has the property clustered equals true. This means, I'm not sure if this is, yeah, it doesn't really explain what a clustered key is. This means that you can, yeah, that each combination of fields entered here, you can enter additional fields like this. Every combination of values which you specified here in these fields will be unique, and yeah, in the background, indices in SQL will be used for this, and this is some fancy SQL background thingy, which leads to a little bit too far now. But you need to know that this is the combination of fields you can identify each record in this table later on with. You'll also use these fields to get a record, meaning something like this. If you just spinning up some, yeah, this doesn't make sense at all on insert, but you'll get the concept that you can use a get to read a record from a table, and you'll need to give the values you specified for the primary key. Okay, enough for on primary keys for now. You can always create more keys, just like this. You can use the snippet T key, and I tend to just numerate my keys, but you can give a nice name for it if you want to. No. Interesting. Okay, and here you can usually. Okay, it seems like you don't need any comma separating it. Interesting. So like this, you can specify a new key, and you can choose just a different field for it for now, like this. And the reason why you want to do this, this would be a valid secondary key. It was called later, earlier in the NAV days. You want to do this if you want to look up or sort quickly by a field which is not a field in the primary key, because SQL Server is way faster in searching in fields which are defined as a key, as a index, than just searching for a value in a field which is just a data field and not specified in any key. I'm not sure since which version, but it also is now sometimes warned if you use fields in code for filtering or something, and it is not defined as a key field. Okay, so a little bit about the properties we have here. Clustered I explained already For the primary key, you can only have one key, which is clustered. Description, yeah, you can describe some stuff, but it is only like documenting for in code. I think this is a property from earlier days, as we can now just comment everywhere in code. So it doesn't really make sense to me. You can disable indices. So it is not, in use anymore. You can also obsolete an index, of course. You can do specify that a index should be unique. So this is similar, like I explained in the primary key. This is by default always unique. But you can also say that my customer number field should be unique in this table. So the user will get an error if he wants to enter a field, a value in this field twice in the table. It's quite forced, because you cannot say, a filter wise or something, or only for a subset of users. This is always, customer number needs to be unique in every constellation for every user always in this table. Sift index and some index fields. With some index fields, you can specify, for example, a total revenue. This is probably a flow field, as I remember, if I remember correctly. So this doesn't make sense. You cannot use flow fields or flow filter fields in relation with keys. Not sure why this is suggested here, but if it would be a normal field, we could say that we want to have our total revenue summed up by customer. So in combination with the sift index, which is a separate setting, this is on by default, true, but you can always disable it. And this combined with the sum index fields saves the sum values for each customer in the background and makes it accessible faster. So if you want to use a calc sums in code, I will show this later for sure and link it later in the description. Then you don't need to loop over your table and sum your fields up manually. You can just filter for your customer number and get the already calculated sum of total revenue right from the database. And this is much faster than doing it manually. Okay, so you can switch it off. You can also switch off the SQL index maintain logic, that you will only have a key in AL and not have it duplicated to SQL Server. Most of the time not needed anymore. And that's it. If you have any questions, something unclear, feel free to leave a comment. And see you later.